Hi everyone, I'm Rama, co-founder and CEO of TOCI, and in today's video we're going to take a look how you can train YOLOv8 on your own custom dataset, but this time for post estimation instead of the usual object detection. Alright, so the first step is to sign up to TOS obviously, so go ahead to the TOCI website and click the sign up button here on the top right corner, fill this input form, and you will have a free account on TOS to follow this tutorial. Alright, here we are on the library section of TOS, and if you go here to post estimation, you will see the leaderboard or with all the algorithms we have now. We have currently YOLOv8 and all of the versions of it, nano, small, medium, large, and extra large. Basically, the one you want to choose is depending on the use case. We're going to use YOLOv8 post nano because it's the fastest one to process videos in real time. But if you care more about the precision of the key point detection, you will go to the extra large version, but you will suffer a bit in performance, in speed, sorry. So we will be a bit slower, but with the nano will be okay for us. Now let's go to the dataset section and create a new one. Let's call it people. Okay, so now I'm going to drop a single image here to upload, and I'm going to tell you why in a few seconds. The reason why I uploaded one image only is because now we have to create the skeleton class of the person. So for every new person that we label, it will have at first the same skeleton, that then we will have to move the keypoints around to match the pose of that particular person. But to get the first skeleton right, I wanted a picture that looks like this, with a person standing in the straight position without moving much. So yeah, let's do that. Let's click start labeling right here on the top right and create a new class called person. Let's change the color here. And now we have to select the post estimation tool. Let's go here and click the plus button to add a new key point. Let's add one here, here and here. All right, so now here in the ears, and the eyes, and finally the nose. All right, now we have to go here and add connections between the key points. So let's do that. Now let's go ahead and change the color for this new connection. Let's use this one. Let's add yellow for the arms. So to remind you, you have to click the first key point and then move the mouse to add the other key point you want to, the other key point from the connection, and click it again and it will form the connection between those two key points. So okay, now we have the first one labeled, and let's go ahead and confirm the skeleton. And now it disappeared because now you have to go ahead and draw a bounding box around the person, and as you can see, you already have here the key points. Let's go ahead and move them a bit because they're not right here. We have to do like that. All right, perfect. Now we can go ahead and submit this. Let's go ahead and drop a few more images. Okay guys, so now I'm uploading 999 images to reach 1000 images in my dataset. Alright guys, let's now label all of the images in the dataset. You have to label all of them. So if you want to label fewer images than 1000, I recommend you to just upload 100 or 500 images, but always label all of them before training. Because if you don't do this, the AI will be confused because it will see that some images where people are indeed present don't have any labels. And it will try to predict the person there, but you are telling it that there's no person there. So it will be confused, literally. So yeah, label all of the images. If you want to see all of the shortcuts, you can click here on this button. That it will show you the list of all the shortcuts we have for the dataset labeling tool. So I'm going to press the A key now. You can press the space key to go into the hand mode while you are labeling. So when I release the space key, now I can make another bounding box if I want to, but let's stay here to move the key points around.
Somewhere, you know I care, but it's so cold and I don't know where. I brought you daffodils on a pretty string, but they won't flower like they did last spring. And I wanna kiss you, make you feel alright. I'm just so tired to share my nights. I wanna cry and I wanna love, but all my tears have been you.
Alright guys, so I finished labeling all of my dataset images. Now I'm here on the train section of Theos. So let's create a new train session called Pose Estimation. Let's select our dataset. Now let's click here, Pose Estimation, and the nano version. Click next. And this is the machine that will do the neural network training. If you're not on the paid plan of Theos, you can either use Google YOLOv8 that will offer you a free GPU from Google, or connect your own GPU from Ubuntu, Python 3.10 at the moment, by running these commands. Your computer will be connected to Theos and you can use it for training. So I'm going to use Google YOLOv8. So let's go ahead and click this. And now we have to run these very few commands we have here. So yeah, let's go ahead and try the first one. This is going to tell us if we have an NVIDIA GPU available here in the notebook. And yes, indeed we have one Tesla T4 GPU. And now I'm installing the Python package from Theos AI. You can ignore this error message here, there's no problem. And now let's run the Theos setup. Here you have to select, obviously, YOLO Pose Estimation. All right, so now we have to go ahead and restart the YOLOv8 runtime, as said here, restart runtime. This is because we installed a few packages that were already installed in the YOLOv8 notebook, but we updated it with another version, so we have to refresh the runtime. All right, now let's log in. And now let's go here and copy the project key and paste it here. Perfect, so now we have here the YOLOv8 notebook connected to Theos. So now let's click it and click create to create the training session. Okay, so the epochs are the number of times that the model will see all of the images in the dataset and try to predict them, predict their bounding boxes and key points. This means that the model will see 300 times all of the images in the dataset, and with each iteration, it will be getting better and better and predicting those key points and bounding boxes. The batch size is the number of images that the model will see in parallel, and this will cause the model to train faster, but it will also require more GPU memory. I will leave it at that. If you want to try different values, feel free to do it, but make sure that the batch size is not big and overflows the GPU memory, basically. So be careful with that. Let's go ahead and click start training now. Okay guys, so I stopped the training here because it wasn't getting much better, the fitness. As you can see here, the fitness is the main metric that you look at to see the performance or the overall performance of the model. So yeah, now let's go ahead and deploy this model to try it out. All right, guys, so now I'm here in the deploy section of Theos. I created a new deployment called post estimation with the best weights of the experiment that we made. Now let's drop some images here to test the model with images that it has never seen. Stop.
On another law, on my tears.
Here you can see the JSON output that you will receive if you use the API. In the overview, you can see here if you use this URL, you will be able to send images to this URL with your any programming language that you choose. So yeah, if you're here to the docs, you will be able to see all of the parameters that you can send to the API. Here you have a few examples how to do it with the command line. Here you have a Python example of how to call the API with an image you have in your disk, and also how to use this in React. If you're making a web application, or you can also use this in React Native. So yes, you can see it's working quite well. We can see the model detects the person in the image and also the key points that we labeled. These are images of people the model has never seen before. So we can see that it generalized very well. Let's try a few more examples.
Another love, oh my tears have been used all on another love,
oh. Alright, working quite well, as you can see. Alright guys, with that we finished the tutorial, I hope you liked it. If you like this content, please like and subscribe if you want to see more of it. And consider also joining the WhatsApp group and the Discord server we have called the Theos AI University, where the Theos AI team and all the community members will be able to help you to succeed in your AI project. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.